Andrea Riseborough has 50 costume changes in this movie. James Darcy has 30. Abbie Cornish has 40 costume changes. It's just a hungry movie for costumes. We have so many costumes. So every day on set is a fashion moment.
Turn over.
Hey, camera.
Yeah. Action.
As you can see, I'm not quite as chic as Andrea is in the film. She had her own style, Elizabeth, and it sort of lived on for generations.
There's a scene in our film where Queen Elizabeth is having a hat fitting. When I read the script, I said, oh my goodness, Stephen Jones has got to play this part.
Now, I was amazed when I got the phone call one day from Madonna saying, could I be in the film? I mean, it was incredible and such an honor.
So actually having Stephen Jones put the hats on your head in a scene is pretty special.
Incredibly.
It's good when you have a laugh. Good. Right, there you go. And it looks lovely on top of that hat.
The jewelry alone is just such a huge part of our film. So we worked with Cartier.
For Cartier, it was very interesting to have such clients like her. You set trends with those kind of women. The Duke spent a lot of money for her, but she also had this taste for jewelry. The Duchess of Windsor was the first to purchase those kind of three-dimension items.
One cross, the Emerald Cross, Edward gives to Wallis when they're on the beach in Cannes.
After we'd finished the scene, Andrew suddenly said, oh, wait a minute, the bracelet with all the other crosses on it, I've lost it.
Yeah.
I don't know how much that thing was worth, but that's somewhere down in about 2 feet of the Mediterranean, the south of France, if you want to go looking for it.
The great thing for me is Madonna really cares about visuals and she really understands costumes. I mean, we have a director that understands couture from the most visceral standpoint of having worn it herself.
Her heart is in a place that is so passionate and so excited about the project that it's difficult not to be swept up by that and want to go the extra mile.
It's just been intensive and I like how all-encompassing it's been, you know, and nothing's taken for granted. I spent about a month and a half working every day with piano teachers, learning by rote, because I've never played piano before, just learning how to play.
And for me, there was French speaking, piano playing, dancing. I've done a lot of classical ballet, so I enjoyed that a lot. Joan Washington, who's an amazing voice coach, she's very specific with each character. And so I would do my work, watching research footage, etc. And we would kind of meet and she'd have done hers and we'd create something that would be right in each specific time period for Wallis. Edward was pretty much like an all-rounder, so there was a lot of riding and bagpipe playing.
Went clay pigeon shooting 3 times a week. Full prosthetics.
I think we started at 6 this morning.
Went dancing every day. I was continuously involved in some learning of some discipline, which massively helped.
And really, within all of that, the most important thing is that you kind of learn it and forget it. And then the moment that she can push us to where we need to be dramatically.
The more experience an actor has, the easier it is for me, the director, because then you're just turning a dial. I was lucky to have a lot of people that fit that description.
We're here in Paris in the new model Citroën here.
Okay.
The reclining mode.
Let's go.
Ready to do some more guerrilla filmmaking.
This film is really ambitious. There's so many scenes. I think we have over 40 locations.
We shot in London, and we shot in the countryside of England. We shot in Wales, and we shot in Manhattan, and we shot in Brooklyn. And we shot in Paris, and we shot in the south of France.
Nice, comfy ride. My holiday is about to begin.